Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Tapestry Church. My name is Kyle, and I'm one of the pastors here, and I just want to give you a really warm welcome from everybody here at Tapestry. Even though we can't see each other, well, yeah, I guess you can see me. This is kind of a one-way relationship at the moment, but even though we can't see each other generally around the church, we want you to know that no matter where you're coming from in life, no matter what you're bringing to church this morning, that we see you and we want to be a church where you are seen. So especially if you're new with us, we just want to say thank you for being here. We know how much courage it takes to show up to a new church, wondering what it's going to be like and how people will receive you. And we just want to say thank you for being here, and we're glad that you're here. For anybody and everybody this morning, we would love for you not to forget to check in. If you have the Church Center app, it's super easy. I'm actually going to do it right now. I just open the Church Center app, click check in, click my name, hit next, and boom, I'm all checked in. So make sure to do that. There's also a moment that's been dropped in the public chat on tapestry.online.church and a link on YouTube Live. Please don't forget to do that. It helps us be a church where nobody falls through the cracks. Friends, we have a great service planned this morning because it's all about Jesus. We're going to be singing about Jesus. We're going to be hearing a great sermon from Pastor Bernard about Jesus and what it means that he is the Messiah or the Christ. And we are going to be enjoying some time in fellowship together. So wherever you are, wherever you're coming from this morning, I want to encourage you, if you're in a spot where you can do this, stand up and sing with us as we sing together in these songs provided by our worship team.
Bread of heaven, send down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word. Bread of heaven, send down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word.
Heaven,
sent down from glory,
sent down from heaven, Truly, you are the living word. I just love that song, especially when the part that says, Jesus, that's what we call you. I love that. Forever saying his name, Jesus, it soothes all doubts and calms all fears. You ought to try it sometimes. But hey, I'm Pastor Bernard. I'm one of the pastors here. And man, I'd like to add my welcome to Pastor Kyle's. You are welcome. And now at this time, we're going to be taking prayer requests. Send in your requests, chat in your requests, whether you're on Church Online, whether you're on YouTube. And hey, there's a platform here where you can request a private prayer. You can request live private prayer during this moment too. So as we sing the next song, chat in your prayer request, please. We're praying about the world. We're praying about fires. We're praying about racial injustice. We're praying about everything this morning. And it's all based on what you sent in to us. And know that there is somebody that cares for you. Know that there's somebody praying for you. And know that there's somebody praying with you. As we sing this next song, let's chat in those requests.
Against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. God will do what he said. He will stand by his word. He will come through. God will do what he said he would do. He will stand by his word. He will come through. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. God will do what he said he would do. He will stand by. He will come through, and I won't be afraid of the arrows by day from the hand of my enemies. I will stand my ground with the Lord on my side, and the stairs that he said will not succeed. Yeah. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work. He said he would do
He said he would do it. Said he would do it. He said he would do it. He said he would do it. He said he would do it. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't burn.
Friends, one of the reasons I love doing a live stream instead of us just putting together all pre-recorded stuff is because we get to pray together. Pretty much everything else that we do in this service, we could put together in pre-recorded videos, but we don't because we love to pray together. Prayers of the people are what make our worship to God smell good to his nostrils and sound like music to his ears. So let's go to God in prayer with these prayer requests that you've chatted in here on the public chat. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you that you are the God who has breathed breath into our bodies. You are the God who woke us up this morning. You are the God who gave us enough hope to show up at church today. For those of us who are struggling to find joy, Lord, you gave us enough to get here today. For those of us who are overwhelmed with everything you've done for us lately, God, you have given us every good gift that we have. So we just thank you for that. We thank you that you alone are God and that every good and perfect gift comes down from you. And this morning we offer our prayer request to you, not because we have earned anything from you, God. We confess that we have done the exact opposite, that we have at times and in various ways turned away from you. We confess that we have contributed to the chaos and the evil in the world in big and small ways. We confess that we have not always loved you with our whole hearts or our neighbors as ourselves. And so we come to you today, not haughty, but humble. Not prideful, but genuinely prayerful, asking you, not because we're good to answer our prayers, but because you're good and we trust you. So this morning, Lord, we pray for Deborah. We pray for the job interview that she has on Wednesday morning at 9 a.m. We pray that you would give her favor in that interview, that she would be able to represent herself well, that you would give her good questions to ask so that she knows the type of situation that she might be getting into in this job, that you would give her clear eyes and a clear mind to discern this role for her, and that if it be your will, Lord, that she would be offered this position. Lord, we also pray for provision and guidance for our sister Mia in different areas of her life. We pray for our brother Jose and our sister Kathy that their immigration paperwork would get processed swiftly and with favorable results, that they would be granted the asylum that they need and seek. God, we pray for wisdom and peace for Matt and Daylene as they consider a new job. We pray that you would give them that in abundance, Lord. And we know that there is wisdom in many counselors. And so we also pray that you would surround them with people who know you and know them and could help them discern that in this process. God, we also pray for some of our own neighbors who have gotten in a fight a little while back, and the police were even having to be involved in some way. And so, Lord, we just pray that you would bring reconciliation in our neighborhood amongst our neighbors. We pray that where there is enmity, where there's strife, where there is disagreement, where there's tension, Lord, that you would bring love and peace and forgiveness and reconciliation. God, we pray for Kim's friend Jennifer, who also has an interview tomorrow. We pray that you would help her to represent herself well and ask really good questions, that she knows the kind of company this is, and so that they know the kind of person she is. God, we also pray for protection from COVID for our sister Ruth for her upcoming trip. We pray, Lord, that you would surround her with your protection, that her trip would leave her safe and healthy. And we also pray for the continued recovery of her friend Nikki. We pray that you would bless her, God. We pray with Lawrence for the Ali family who is dealing with their father Joe being in a motorcycle accident yesterday. We pray for his surgeries this morning that you would give the doctors sure hands and minds to do what he needs for them to do for his healing to be complete. God, we pray for the comfort of the family as well. Lord, we also pray for Steve and Grace as they prepared to get married on December 5. We're so excited for them, God. We are so grateful that you have brought them together, not only in life, but also in ministry and the type of ministry that you've called them to. God, we're so joyful with them, and we pray for these next few months as they prepare themselves for marriage that you would give them all kinds of wisdom, that you'd give them peace, that you would help them to discern the things they need to discern, not just to have a beautiful wedding, but to have a beautiful married life. God, we pray for our friends who are seeking during this time of during these times of hardship, friends who are asking questions, maybe even people who are watching this morning on our service who are asking questions about where are you, God, and who are you, and what do you have to say about all the things that are going on in this world? We pray for those who are seeking right now, Lord, that you would show yourself to them as you've shown yourself to us. We pray that they would have an experience of you. Frankly, that we all would have an experience of you because we are all seeking you in some way, shape, or form. That's why we're here this morning. And so with them, God, we pray that you would show yourself to us. God, we also pray for our sister Shawanda that her COVID test would come back negative. She's been under the weather with food poisoning and a pinched nerve. God, we pray that you'd heal her body. And God, we pray with Yina for her family that everyone would be drawn closer and closer to Jesus again. Father, we love you. We pray all these things because we trust you and we believe in your goodness and in your power. So we leave these prayers in your hands. We know that you're a good God, and we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's been good praying with you all. And as we move into the next portion of our service, I also want to share with you a few ways that we can be together as a church. The first way, and I want to remind those of you who maybe didn't catch it right at the beginning of the service, we would ask that you please check in today. It helps us to be a church where nobody falls through the cracks. And it also, over time, it gives us really helpful information that we can use to make wise decisions about the life of the church. So please check in today. There will be that check-in moment dropped in the public chat once again in the next few moments here. Or you can check in on the Church Center app on your phone. The second thing I want to share with you today is we are going to have really our first in-person gathering of sorts, even though it's going to be socially distanced and very safe. This Saturday, we're going to have a picnic and pick up, a way for us to gather in community at a distance, but also support our broader community in Oakland, because as a church, we exist for the city of Oakland and to show them the love of God. So we're actually going to be meeting at San Antonio Park in East Oakland at 11 a.m. on Saturday. We're going to start by picking up trash in the park. We know that the city has ramped down some services because of COVID, and so some trash has been left over that normally might get picked up by this point, but we're going to start by picking up that trash and just showing some love in a tangible way to our community for about an hour or however long it takes for us to get through the park. And then we're going to sit down for a picnic together. It's a sort of a bring your own picnic, because we don't want to contaminate each other. We're going to stake out circles for people to socially distance and in their households. And so it's going to be very safe, but we would encourage you to come if you want to see the faces of your brothers and sisters and the people that you're worshiping with here today. Especially if you're new with us, it's a great way to actually get to know some of the people that you have been worshiping with for the past few months. So we would encourage you to come this weekend, Saturday, San Antonio Park, picnic and pick up. We also want to just remind everybody who would call Tapestry Church their home, we want to remind you to pledge today. If you haven't yet pledged, pledging your gift, pledging your tithe or your donation to Tapestry over the course of this next fiscal year from September to August is a really, really great way to grow your spiritual life, to make a commitment of trust to God who has given you everything that you have, of just a portion of that back into his service and through the ministry of the church. So we would encourage you to pledge your gift in that way. It also really, really helps us as we plan out this coming ministry year to make really good decisions so that we as a church can thrive and grow in the ways that God is calling us to do that. Those are my three announcements for today. And without further ado, I'm gonna bring in Pastor Bernard, our lead pastor, who has a great message for us from the book of Luke.
Let's pray, shall we? Father God, in the name of Jesus, we praise you, we honor you, and we thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity that we would be able to break the bread of life to your people. Lord, we know preaching belongs to you. Man is just a vessel you decided to use. We pray that you would use us now, Lord, for your glory, that you would be glorified, that the church would be edified, and the devil would be horrified. And Lord, I don't know what it is about me, but it makes me feel better when I say, Lord, I need you. I need you now, Lord. Help us to preach as never before, like a dying man to dying men and women. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, you could guess how excited I was when I got the invitation from Pastor Bernard to be your speaker this morning and just to share my testimony. Pastor Bernard told me that you all were in a series, this Who is Jesus series. And he just thought that my experience with Jesus being the Messiah might be helpful to a few of you this morning. I know that Pastor Kyle said, and I know that you're expecting Pastor Bernard, but Pastor Bernard asked me to stand in for him and give my testimony this morning on who Jesus is. So if you will, follow me to Luke, the 23rd chapter, verses 39 through 43. And it says, one of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us. But the other criminal rebuked him. Don't you fear God, he said, since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly for what we are getting, what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong. Then he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus answered him, truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise. And from that passage of scripture, I just want to share my testimony this morning. I just want to share what Jesus is to me. So let me tell you a little bit about myself. You could say that I am a nobody. Yes, I come from a long line of nobodies. Nobody's running my family. I'm not named like Bartimaeus or Zacchaeus or even Nicodemus. I'm given no facial description. There are no outstanding qualities to describe me or that I could even brag about. There isn't even a place to say where I come from. I am a nobody. No face, no name, no place to come from. I'm just a nobody. You see, my whole existence in biblical history can be summed up in one adjective. And that word is criminal. You see, I grew up in a God-fearing Jewish home. My parents were God-fearing people. And as a boy, I was taught to reverence God. I had this healthy fear of God growing up. I grew up with a healthy fear of Him. I was taught all the customs and traditions of my people, but as time went by, they began to get old to me. They began to wear on me. They began to play out. So it was at that time that I figured I needed to go my own way. I figured I needed to establish my own agenda. I just noticed that I danced to the beat of a different drummer. You know, those old ways, they were fine for my parents, but they didn't suit me at all. So by the time I was 16, I began to realize what I wanted to do. By the time I was 16, I had made up in my mind what I wanted to be. By the time I was 16, I had figured out that I wanted to be a criminal. Not only did I want to be a criminal, but I wanted to be the best criminal there was. I mean, you tell me, if your whole existence in biblical history is summed up in being a criminal, you want to be the best criminal you could be. You know, so I worked at it. I worked at it from a boy on into my adulthood. I worked at it. I was good, but I even got better because I practiced. I was good, but I even got better because I took pride in it. I was good, but I even got better because this is what I wanted to be for the rest of my life, a criminal. You know, people used to say that I had very sticky fingers as a boy. That's probably what led me that way. And some used to say that I was so good, I could steal the sweetness out of sugar. What you say? Some would even say, boy, you're so slick, you don't need no grease. Yeah, I was that good. But I even got better. You see, I was about that life. I was there and I was thugging it out. And I never left home without a blade. You know, a sharp blade is a thug's best friend. And we used to roll through Nazareth, set tripping on them fools all the time. And so I heard of Jesus. I heard of Jesus because I stayed banging on his hood. And if anybody needs a translation, I'll be available after service. But I stayed banging on his hood. I was out there and I was doing my thing and I was thugging it out and I was living it up. I was banging on other hoods, especially Nazareth. While I was out there doing my thing, one day my luck ran out. One day it all had to come to a crashing end, a crashing halt, but I was caught on a burglary. And not only was I caught on the burglary, but they added 4 enhancement charges to me. And needless to say, there's a difference when crimes are committed by Jews. There's a difference in crimes that are committed by Jews and crimes that are committed by Romans. If I was Roman, they probably would have gave me 3 to 5 years in prison. But since I'm a Jew, they sentenced me to death by crucifixion. That's one of the worst forms of capital punishment. It was made especially for the hardened, the worst criminals and nobodies. And I was both of these. Who's to say I probably deserve it? I don't think I deserve death, but I did deserve some time. So on the day when I was crucified, on the day that they set aside for me to be crucified, the day I was sentenced to be crucified, there were two others that were crucified with me. And to my left was a man named Jesus. And I wonder, was it the same guy that I heard about from Nazareth? And to his left, to Jesus's left, there was another nameless criminal, another nobody. Now, I knew the criminal. I knew the criminal. We did some work together back in the day, but Jesus I only had heard about. I knew the criminal, but Jesus I only had heard about. I heard good things about him. Everything I heard about him was to the good. One thing I heard about him in particular, I heard that he had a compassionate heart for nobodies like me. I heard stories how he healed a blind man. I had heard stories about one day he healed a man at the pool called Bethesda. I had heard stories about him healing a woman with the blood issue. I had heard stories about him healing a possessed man. I had heard stories about him feeding 5,000 people. If this was that Jesus, I heard he cared about nobodies. I heard he cared about the least of these. I heard that he had grace for the hood. And it was at this time, the same man who worked the miracles, who had served the hood, if this was the same man, then I figure his claim to be the Son of God had to be true. But he was being crucified along with us. He was being crucified with me and the other criminal. And I wonder how the police could have made this mistake. Because if this was that Jesus, he was being charged with crimes he didn't commit. You know, I saw them. I saw them put this crown that they had made out of thorns on his head. And I watched as people spit on him. They placed the sign over his head that said, "This is the King of the Jews." And I noticed that he had been beaten. And I heard people laugh at him. I heard people teasing him. I heard people cursing and mocking him. And it was at this time that one of the most incredible things I had ever witnessed in my life happened. This Jesus, he said a prayer for those cursing, for those mocking, and for those teasing him. It is one of the most incredible things I had ever witnessed before in my life. I heard him say, "Father, forgive them, because they don't know what they're doing." It was at that moment that I realized this was the Jesus that I had heard about. He was actually praying for them. They don't know what they're doing, because if they knew what they're doing, they wouldn't have done it. "Father, forgive them." It was incredible. And they were yelling at him, "Come down and save yourself." I didn't know it then, but what was happening was this. they challenged him to save himself from the cross. But instead, he saved others by the cross. And it was at this very moment, would you know that other criminal yelled at him, "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." His words, they stung me to my heart. His words, they stung my heart. "Aren't you the Messiah? Save yourself and us." And his words, they hurt me, because I knew this was the Messiah. I knew this was the Jesus who saves. I knew that this was Emmanuel, God with us. Realizing this, I yelled at that fella. I yelled at that other criminal. I said to him, "Don't you fear God? We're getting what we deserve, but this man has done nothing wrong." In other words, don't involve me in your junk. That's on you, brother. That's on you. And I looked at Jesus and I realized that I was actually looking in the face at the Son of God. I realized that I was actually looking in the face of the one who saves. I realized that I was actually looking in the face of Emmanuel. I realized I was looking in the face of the Messiah. And I said to him, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." You know, I was taught to pray as a boy, but the prayers I learned were much longer than this. But I realized it doesn't take much. All you have to say is, "Lord, remember me." He told me, "Today you will be with me in paradise." These words rang in my soul, as you can imagine. And it all began to come back to me. "Today, choose who you will serve today. And it all began to make sense, because I was face to face with the Messiah. I was face to face with Jesus. I was face to face with Noah's rainbow. I was face to face with Abraham's ram in the bush. I was face to face with Isaac's whale. I was face to face with Jacob's ladder. I was face to face with Joseph's bread and hunger. I was face to face with Moses' rod. I was face to face with David's good shepherd. I was face to face with Solomon's lily of the valley. I was face to face with Ezekiel's wheel in a wheel. I was face to face with Isaiah's wonderful Counselor, the everlasting God, the mighty God, the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. I was face to face with the Messiah." Yes, I was face to face with Jesus, the Messiah, with Jesus, the one who saves, with Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. I knew it was all right then. I knew everything would be all right. His words were comforting to me. "Today, you will be with me in paradise." Well, that's my testimony to the church this morning, that I was face to face with the Messiah. And I want to thank Pastor Bernard for allowing me to come by and share with you this morning. I also want to thank Pastor Kyle for being a wonderful host to me this morning. Remember, I'm just a nobody trying to tell everybody about somebody that can save anybody. Shall we pray? Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, we honor you, and we praise you for your preached word. Lord, we thank you, God, for being the Messiah. Lord, we thank you for being Jesus, God in the flesh. We thank you for being the one who saves. We thank you for being Emmanuel, God with us. Lord, and if there was someone here that does not know you this morning, Lord, we pray that they got a proper introduction. And God, we pray, Holy Spirit, that you would do your regenerating work and save them in the stillness and quietness of their heart. Save them now, God. And Lord, for those of us that know you, we pray that something was said that we would be brighter lights and saltier salt. Lord, we pray that people would see your love in us and they come asking, what must I do that I might be saved? Thank you for hearing us, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Man, thank you. Wait, should I call you Pastor Bernard now? Or?
No, I'm still in mode.
Oh, okay. All right. I'm not going to break character here.
Criminal.
Thank you, criminal, for preaching. Well, and that's a beautiful thing, actually, about the church, right? Is that all of us, at some level, recognize ourselves in a criminal. And that God raises up criminals to be preachers of his good news.
Yes.
And I mean, that's not just the person in this story. That's me. That's you. That's all of us.
Yeah.
So praise God for that. And this morning, as we move into this communion moment, I'm struck by the sermon this morning that basically when we come to God in communion, what we're doing is we're participating in a foretaste of paradise.
Mm.
Right, this meal that we take together, it represents that great feast at the end of time that we are going to be sharing around the table with Jesus.
Yes.
That great feast where all of God's people from every tribe, tongue, and nation will be sharing the table, will be sharing in the worship of God.
Mm.
And that means that basically as we come to this table this morning, we are in our souls, in the way that we receive the bread and the juice, we are saying, Jesus, remember me.
Remember me.
When you come into your kingdom at that last day.
Yes.
And I guarantee you, friends, that if that is your plea, if that is where your heart is at as you receive this meal with us this morning, that he will respond to you. He will be your Messiah too. In the same way that he was with the criminal, and he will say, today, you will be with me in paradise.
Yeah.
So, friends, as we come to the table this morning, we remember that night that Jesus was to be betrayed. He took a piece of bread, and as he was blessing it, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, his friends around the table, and he said, take and eat. This is my body, which is for you. Do this every time you eat it in remembrance of me.
And after that, he took the cup and he said, this cup is the New Testament and my blood, which is shed for many for the forgiveness of sin. And I want you to drink all of it. And they did. And as often as we eat the bread and drink the cup, we do publicly proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again.
So if that is something that you can publicly proclaim, that Jesus' death and resurrection saves you, that you have said, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom, then friends, welcome to the table.
Yes.
You do not have to be perfect, and far from it. You have to recognize yourself in the criminal, like all of us do. And if you're somebody this morning who is still struggling to figure out what you believe about God, you're not quite sure what to make of the claims that Jesus is the Messiah, that he is the one who saves, that he is God with us, that's okay. We're so glad that you're here. We just want you to be able to move forward in your relationship with God from where you are, not from where somebody else needs you to be.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're here this morning and you're still struggling with that, we would encourage you to sort of let this moment of receiving the bread and the cup pass you by, but don't let this moment pass you by. Take the time in the song to pray, to ask God, how do you want to commune with me? To ask him to remember you and show up for you in the way he's done for so many others. And if you're someone here who was moved by the criminal sermon and you recognize yourself in that moment that he was in on the cross, noticing and recognizing for the first time who Jesus really is, we want to encourage you to lift up your hand and say, hey, I want to follow this Jesus. Mm. I want this Jesus to remember me. We're going to, during this next song, we're going to drop a moment in the public chat that will empower you to raise up your hand publicly. And it's not going to say who you are. It's not going to say your name. But what it will do is give you an opportunity to click that button again to connect with us and share your contact info with us so that we pastors can reach out to you and support you on your journey in following Jesus. So friends, however we're sharing this time, this is a time for all of us to commune with God from the place that we're coming from. So friends, as we sing this next song, grab your bread, grab your cup. These are the gifts of God for the people of God.
Blessed be to God.
Father's arms are
Friends, as we come to this giving part of our service, the part where we not only recognize what Jesus has given us, but have an opportunity to give something of ourselves back to Him, I can't help but wonder, in thinking about the sermon this morning, if we met the criminal in the kingdom of heaven, if we met him in paradise, and we asked him, what would you be willing, what are you willing, what have you been willing to give Jesus, the Jesus who said, today you will be with me in paradise, I would hazard guess that he would say, what do you mean? What am I not willing to give back to him who gave me everything that I have, who gave me life, who gave me eternity? That's what I think he would say. And this moment, friends, this is not a moment where we come to give our gifts to God out of obligation. This is not a moment where we come to give our gifts to God in a way of thinking like, well, how much can I pry loose from my own grip? This is a moment where we recognize how much Jesus has given to us, and where we joyfully and cheerfully give whatever he is calling us to give back to his service. So if you are a member of Tapestry Church, if you'd consider yourself part of our church and you are down for the mission that we are on together, we'd encourage you to give to the ministry of this church. There's gonna be a giving moment dropped right now in the public chat for you to just click through and give that way, or you can give on the app or by text message. Any number of ways that you can give this morning. I also want to encourage you that if you are a part of Tapestry Church, as I mentioned before, to go ahead and pledge your gift for this coming year. Prayerfully consider how much God might be calling you to give on a consistent basis as a commitment of your life, more than just sort of an ad hoc, what can I do this week? But if you are somebody who is here this morning for the first time, or you're not sure what you think about who Jesus is and you're still trying to sort that out for yourselves, let me be really clear. Your presence here is gift enough to us. Okay, we don't want your money. We give here out of an abundance of what God has already given us. So if you are new here, we just want to say thank you for being here. And we want to encourage you, along with the rest of the church, to grow in generosity, however you can see fit to do that this week. We're going to have an opportunity to intentionally do that as we move into this next song before we end our service. So I encourage you to stick in, to pray, to ask God, how do you want me to show up in giving for you this week out of all that you have given me?
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness veils his lovely face, rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. us then to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all of the ground is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all of the ground is sinking sand.
Guest speaker, it was hard for me to get him to come by and share his testimony, but you know, his schedule was full and all of that, but he was able to squeeze us in this morning. So I thank the criminal for showing up for us this morning. Also, but today, immediately after service, we are having an after party. Yes, so we'll see you all at the after party. You can find the Zoom link in the notes section on Tapestry Online Church and on YouTube. Pastor Kyle will enter it in the notes. So remember, the after party, immediately after church today, we'll probably hang out a bit, listen to some music, and then join the after party. And if nothing else, check in. If you haven't checked in, you can always check in now. And check in is a new thing we added to our platform. That way we can stop people from slipping through the cracks. And, you know, in churches, people come in the front door and they go right out the back, and this will prevent that, and it will provide us with some useful data in the future. So if you haven't already, check in. And if nothing else, at Tapestry Church, we like to put our hands out in a position of receptivity, and go ahead and do that, and let me give you all a blessing. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. And all God's people said, amen, amen, and amen.
Mm-hmm.